The death toll from the asylum boat crash has risen to 5, but around 90 passengers are still lost at sea.
Poor weather is hampering the search, and authorities now say it is unlikely any more survivors will be found. 10 political reporter Leah Craven joins us now live from Canberra. And Leah, there's going to be a criminal investigation into this tragedy.
Yes, Matt, there have been extra federal police officers who've been sent to Christmas Island to assist the ones who were already there, try to get to the bottom of how this tragedy unfolded. But first, asylum seekers have the opportunity to have health checks. They can call family members to let them know that they're safe. And then the AFP will start to interview people. They'll try to figure out what the circumstances were as to how these asylum seekers got on the boat and whether this will give them any indication as to who the people smugglers were. There have been reports that two of the survivors on the boat were crew members. So the AFP will be investigating this because that's obviously illegal, but there'll also be a coronial inquest because of the deaths.
Shocked and exhausted after a terrifying ordeal, the remaining 16 survivors are brought to Christmas Island, treated for hypothermia and dehydration. Three men with more serious injuries have been sent to Perth. Hope is fading for those still lost at sea.
The bodies of 5 people have also been recovered. Around 90 people remain unaccounted for.
One Sydney family is desperately awaiting news of their Iraqi cousin they believe is on board.
They did not receive any phone call from him, which is a bad indication that he's not one of the people who were rescued.
Tomorrow marks 2 years since Julia Gillard deposed Kevin Rudd as Prime Minister, and one of the key areas she said needed to be fixed was asylum policy.
2 years on, not much has changed, but the PM won't comment.
My focus is not on the politics or the policy debates. Search and rescue mission is still in progress.
Labor's called for a political truce to end the impasse on offshore processing.
We want to work together across the parliament to secure an outcome that reduces the possibility of a tragedy like this being repeated.
But Tony Abbott won't budge and support legislation to overcome a High Court rejection of the Malaysia solution.
What's important here is effective policies, not necessarily bipartisan policies.
The Greens don't support it either.
This is a humanitarian issue. You don't solve humanitarian issues with quick political fixes.
Refugee groups agree and call for an end to the political point scoring on an issue that's a matter of life and death.
Now, both Labor and the Coalition do agree on the fact that offshore processing is the best way to deter people from making these dangerous boat journeys to Australia. But what they can't agree on is where to send asylum seekers, to Malaysia or Nauru. Now, from what we heard, the Coalition isn't going to budge on its stance, neither are the Greens, to help put this legislation through. So what we'll be looking for is to see whether the government's willing to give any ground here or whether this political stalemate will just continue.
Leah, thank you.
Now, the stricken boat that had been bringing the asylum seekers to Australia has now sunk, complicating the federal police investigation. Michael Bennett is on Christmas Island, where he filed this report.
Thanks. Conditions off Christmas Island are hampering the search. 2 metre swells, 25 knot winds and white caps, making the task of spotting survivors from the air nearly impossible. But regardless, 4 planes and 4 large vessels are still looking for the living. The latest information we have is that a decision will be made on scaling back the rescue effort to a recovery mission very soon. We've been told that planes have spotted more dead bodies from the air, but that the rescue effort is still concentrating on survivors. We spoke a short time ago with a customs official who told us of the gratitude expressed by the survivors who arrived here on Christmas Island last night.
They were very thankful. A lot of them shook their hands as they came off, you know, as they were being offloaded. They made an effort to shake the crew's hands.
One more seriously injured survivor has been flown back to Perth, and the Department of Immigration says that those receiving treatment on the island are a priority.
What we're doing is focusing on their well-being and ensuring that we facilitate what we call a live call so that they can contact their relatives, let them know they're safe.
A mass contingent of WA police arrived on the island a short time ago. Most here are suspecting that death toll will continue to climb. That's the latest from Christmas Island.